Welcome to Vlogmas Day 6, you guys. I want to show you, I just made a green smoothie. I was already drinking out of it, so it doesn't look as pretty anymore. But I just did a bunch of spinach, which is why it's so green. And, okay, it's gonna sound weird, but there's actually, I put a bunch of peanut butter and banana in there. So the green is probably like throwing you off, but it's like pretty peanut buttery, banana-y. And so I threw some of this chocolate granola on top, Pearly Elizabeth chocolate sea salt, and it's so freaking good, you guys. Like, the green is kind of throwing me off too, but it doesn't taste like spinach at all, obviously, because it doesn't really taste like anything. And so it's so, so good right now. Isn't that yummy, buddy? We just went on the longest walk. I'm having the best morning. It's way later, I'm sure you can tell. I just showered, all clean, did my makeup, blow dried my hair, curled my hair a little bit. This is one thing I've been loving about Vlogmas, is just like getting ready every day. I feel like it's been making me feel so confident, I don't know, and like the best version of me. So I've been having so much fun like getting all ready every day. And yeah, just like a little light curling moment with my curling iron in my hair. And I wanted to shout out one specific product, you guys, that I would be nothing without, the Way leave-in conditioner. Seriously, I don't know where I would be without my leave-in conditioner. We have like very special relationship because I have so much hair, as you can tell, and it's so long, but it's very fine. And so what that means is it gets very tangly. I'm sure you guys have heard me talk about my holy grail leave-in conditioner before, but if you missed it, if you haven't, basically it just makes my hair like smooth, shiny, manageable, and bottom line, it makes it so I can get a brush through my hair when it's wet. Because even though I use a wet brush, I literally cannot get a brush through my hair. I need to get, I'm sure you guys have seen me before when I get out of the shower, my hair is just like in knots because it gets so tangly, like I've been saying. So I spray this all over my hair, brush through it, and it actually has heat protect in it, which is amazing. It protects your hair from heat up to 450 degrees. It's so nice knowing that when I'm curling my hair that there's already like heat protection on. I don't even have to worry about it. My skin is dry, my hair is dry, everything's dry. And so if I don't use this, my hair will just be like so frizzy, flyaways, and so it really helps like smooth, shiny hair. I'm sure you guys can tell. But like I was saying, if you're in the market for a new leave-in conditioner, if you want the best one ever, if you don't have the Way leave-in conditioner already, I'll have it linked down below. You can go to Way's website, that's theouai.com, and use my code GG, and you can get 15% off your entire purchase. Way, you guys know I love their detox shampoo, I love their hand soap, hand lotion, I love their like leave-in treatment conditioner. I'm a huge Way fan, so yes, my code GG will get you 15% off your entire purchase. And now I've been feeling like it's time for an honest life update, you guys. I've been feeling this way because I did one 2 Vlogmases ago, I did one last year, and I'm just thinking about, I was looking back at like how much life has changed since my life update last year. I like doing these honest life updates during Vlogmas because then I can look back at like the year before, and I don't know, I feel like I've just been in my feels today. I've been kind of like emo and like sad, so I don't know, I just thought it could be a good time to talk to you guys, since I just feel like cuddling with Brody and like I feel like I'm gonna cry already in this moment. But yeah, I just want to like update you on life and like get cozy and go chit chat. Did I say it's because, maybe it's because it's Sunday? I feel like on Sunday I'm like, especially because I'm alone, I'm just like in my feels. Let's go have a chat. Got my Barefoot Dreams blankie. We're getting all cozy so that we can have our very honest and real like life update chit chat. I feel like that's weird if I'm like this, I look naked. We just have this down here. This is like my security blanket while I'm being real and open with you guys. So I guess how I've been doing, like everything is good. Let me just start by saying everything's great. Everything's really great. And I just feel like sometimes I try to remind myself that when, because I will catch myself noticing like there'll be things that you want, you know, that you are working towards for a long time. And then you get there and you are like accomplishing things that you've always wanted to accomplish, your goals, or you're like, you know, like you look at things like, if only I was there, and then you are there, but then you don't even like take a moment to realize it and appreciate it, and you're already like on to the next thing. Like what I'm trying to say is I feel like sometimes everything's good and there like shouldn't be something to be sad about or complain about, but you like still find something. So I try to like tell myself that. I'm like, Gretchen, you're fine, everything's fine. You just like try to find things to complain about. Okay. For example, like last year when I was looking back at my little life update, I really was having a hard time. Last December, and I hadn't made like a single friend here. Like I hadn't met anyone yet, anyone like new in Pennsylvania. Like I had a couple friends that I already knew, like outside of Philly from college, whatever. But it was really hard being here, especially since hockey season didn't start yet because of COVID. It started so late last season, they didn't start till like February. And so it was like literally just Max and I here in Pennsylvania. I had like no friends or anything. I feel like I was really lonely, and because I was lonely, it made me like more sad all the time. I feel like I'm being so real right now. Like this made me sad thinking about just like, yeah, how I was doing last winter. And so yeah, I feel like since I felt lonely, it made me feel sad even more and like miss my dad and stuff like that. But update for this year, like I'm doing so good. Like I'm doing really great friend wise and I have nothing to complain about. Like I just feel so lucky, like the group of girls that are here this year, like that's like really my group of friends here. But I just feel like so blessed that Max's job comes sort of like built in friends for me in a way, with just his teammates having wives and girlfriends that are also here, and we all just sort of like understand each other and just get the situation. Like for example, if I like I really can't ever make a plan because, sorry, this is how my brain works, just like all over the place. But Max has been so up and down this hockey season. Like he's got called up, sent down maybe 10 times. I'm not even kidding. Like it can be so often. And because of that, I can't really like make plans for like, okay, which games am I going to, anything like it. Like I just find out the day of, and so it's really hard if I make plans to go to a game with, like this happened recently with like I have friends from childhood, and then I feel so bad and I'm like, wait, I just found out like he's not playing in this game today, like we can't go, like he's going here. And so yeah, it's just, what I'm trying to say is it's nice having girlfriends here that like understand the situation, and like I don't know, because we're all in a similar situation, so we all like get it, and I feel like can bond very quickly since like we're moving to a place that is completely new and we really don't know anybody here, and we're all just here for the same reason, for our husbands, our fiancés, our boyfriends' job. And so it's been so nice like having friends this year. And obviously last year I ended up having friends once the hockey season started, but last December I was in just like a rough place, only ever seeing Max and Brody. And I mean, especially during the pandemic too, like it was just hard to see people, make friends. And like this year, even going to like fitness classes and just being social with neighbors and things like that, like I'm just feeling so good in that department. But along with that, I'm also feeling like so much better spending time alone, which I'm so proud of myself. Like I could like cry thinking about it, because I used to be really bad at spending time alone, and I know it sounds dumb, but like I didn't know how. And I just feel like I've gotten so good at enjoying my own company and like learning how, in a way, like taking myself on dates and like enjoying my own company and like planning things for myself. Like I feel like I'm learning to like love myself more and like love who I am. And I don't know, I just feel like spending time alone makes you think more like how I am right now. I'm being emo. I don't know why that's like emotional for me to say, but I think like never wanting to spend time alone or never wanting to be alone, like maybe I didn't want to confront with like how I actually like felt about myself or even think about things like self-confidence or being okay on my own or like doing my own things. And I don't know, I just feel like I've gotten so much better with that, and like I've kind of had to because Max is away so much. Like he's away right now. See, maybe that's why I'm emo on a Sunday, because it's a Sunday and I'm like, it gets dark so early and I just am in my head like thinking. But like honestly, I am so proud of myself and how far I've come with like being okay on my own. And like I feel like my support system here, like all my girlfriends, has really allowed for that, because especially when Max is like away for weeks at a time or something, it's like I can have my social life and still see friends and like have people that have my back, but then I can still like be independent and like a functioning human being over here on my own. Just know if you struggle being alone or with self-love and stuff, that it is always, I mean, for me, maybe it's easier for some people, but for me it's like such a journey, and I'm always like working on it and have to sort of prioritize being independent and doing my own thing and not just like going over to one of the girls' house and staying there all day. It's like, Gretchen, you can like live your own life and do what you want to do. I know that sounds dumb, but just maybe if any of you have related to like struggling with independence, maybe this like sounds familiar. And so it's like very freeing that I'm like, I can be here and like make my own plans and do my own thing. everything. And I still feel like I'm the type of person that feels overwhelmed all the time. Like I can just feel very overwhelmed very easily, especially during Vlogmas. I can get like so overwhelmed with like all that I feel like I have to do like on my plate. My mind is just like always running of things that I feel like I have to do. But another good thing about being alone a lot is that it forces me to focus and be productive. And so that's kind of been really nice, honestly, for being alone, is being able to focus in on like the work that I'm doing and plan out my videos and stuff like that. So yeah, life update for this year is that, I mean, a part of my life update right now is that I've gotten really good at being alone, but also feel like I have such a nice balance of like spending time by myself and like making plans for myself, but then also making plans with friends and making it a priority to be social and have fun, because that I just know I'm like thriving as a human being and feel a lot better. Like I feel like my social life is a part of like my health in a way and my well-being, and it's like so important for me to like be social and see friends and everything for so many reasons, and especially since I'm like so extroverted. Okay, morning, here's where I might really cry, but I feel like a hard part, see, there's like benefits and drawbacks, pros and cons. A hard part maybe for me being alone is thinking so much. I need to like turn on Selling Sunset and like stop letting my brain think. But yeah, I'll just like miss my dad more, obviously, because I have like time on my hands to think about him and miss him. Like immediately as I start talking about him, I'm like tearing up. And honestly, Thanksgiving was quite hard. And I'm always like, this year will be different, this year will be better. Like it's another year later. And I just found myself feeling like, I feel like I try to like bury it so deep down sometimes. And like not feel like, because I'm like, Christian, you're fine. Like it was years ago, like you're okay. It's okay, like this is your new normal, it's fine. And so like I won't even know why, like on this Thanksgiving, it was like later on in Thanksgiving, and I was talking to my cousin Mandy, and I was like, I'm just feeling so weird today. Like I feel really like disjointed or disconnected, or like it doesn't feel like Thanksgiving, and like I don't know, I just feel like not on the same page with everyone else, like being so happy celebrating Thanksgiving. And I'm like, I think it's because I miss my dad. I'm so happy that I'm so close with my family and we can all relate to like her losing her uncle. And her parents, my aunt, uncle, were actually like talking about my dad at dinner. We always do like a little toast and like pray and say grace and everything like that. And my aunt, uncle were speaking about my dad and crying. And I felt like, I don't know, it was just so sweet, like that I don't feel hear the tears like alone and grieving, because like that was one thing I remember. I'm all over the place right now. When I lost my dad, I'm just like, it feels so isolating. I know I've always talked about that, and it's so bizarre that you feel like the only one that's ever lost a parent, because so many people lose their parents. I almost have to remind myself, like, because I'm just like, oh, he's my dad, like, and he's my sister's dad, and he's my mom's husband, and like it's so hard on us. But then I forget that like my cousin can be sad, like that's her uncle, and like my friends can be so sad, like they're so close to me, that's my dad, you know. Like I forget that other people are like grieving his loss too, and so it feels so nice that like we can relate on that and whatever. And I just, the reason I wanted to talk about this is because if you are someone who like goes through a rough time during the holidays, if you've lost someone, especially an immediate family member, if you've gone through loss, like it is so just like comes in waves, I'm sure you know, if you deal with grieving. And so I just want to like validate your feelings, that if you feel off during the holidays and like disconnected and weird, like I feel just like numb to emotions sometimes, which I feel like is a sort of common reaction to like trauma or something like that. I just want to validate your feelings, and it's so normal, and I just feel like we all need to be okay with like feeling off and feeling sad, especially during holidays when it's a time that you would like typically all be with family and like have happy memories from the past and stuff. Like it's okay to be sad, and a lot of people are sad and are going through a tough time during the holidays. I hope my words are still coming out. And it's so normal, and we can't like compare our holiday and like what's going on, our traditions and stuff, to anybody else, because like that's not fair. And obviously everyone's experience is different, but I just can find myself being sad, being like, why is this time like rainbows and sunshine for like everyone else, and like the holidays can be such a happy time for other people, but like not for me. Like I just miss my dad and think about him like whipping out his video camera when we would like run down the stairs to open presents on Christmas. But then it's like everyone goes through hard things, everyone loses someone close to them, and so you just have to remind yourself like you're not alone. Okay. We're okay. Just needed a breather. Oh, it's always hard to talk about, and I'm always like, even like when I know I'm gonna talk about my dad, like filming, I'm like, this time will be different. Like it's been a while, I'm used to it. Like I've talked about it so much on YouTube, and then I start talking, and
And another reason I've like missed my dad extra this year, because I was thinking about the differences between like life this year and last year. And last year, honestly, thinking about it, like if you would have told Max and I last December when I was filming my little life update that a year later he would have had his NHL debut this season and played in several NHL games for the Philadelphia Flyers and like been called up and sent down this year a bunch, and it would be like such an exciting, crazy, hectic season, like I don't even know if we would have believed you. Like we just, it's been like such an exciting season for Max, and obviously that's him and not me, but just, I'm sure you guys know, if you are in a relationship, like your partner's success and like being fulfilled and being so happy is like the best feeling ever, and it's like really his dream come true. So in a way it feels like my dream come true, because like I'm just so happy for him. I feel like it's just made me miss my dad even more, and like any big life thing that happens, like when he had his NHL debut, I know I talked about it in that video how I was just thinking about his Nana, who would have like loved to be there so much, and like I think about her so often, I think about my dad so often, who would have loved to be there, and like I just wish I could call him and like tell him that like Max's dreams were coming true. He would be so happy for him. I'm just so happy for us, like living in Pennsylvania. Like I'm always like I want to show him my apartment. Like he never got to meet Brody. I just want to like fill him in on life. So yeah, I don't know, I feel like that's been hard and made me feel his absence even more. When like something big and exciting happens, I just want to share that with him, and he's like the first person I still to this day like think of to call when something happens. Really did not think I was going to cry this much. Of course, as I was just telling you guys how I'm like, I've been loving getting ready every day. It's like so nice as I'm like crying off all my makeup. I just really like, especially if any of you are going through a hard time in December, like especially Thanksgiving, Christmas, whatever holidays you celebrate, it can just bring up hard, difficult feelings that can be sad. And so I just like don't want you to feel alone in that, and know that even if you see me like skipping around through my Instagram stories, like petting Brody and like frolicking in the snow and twirling around with matching pajamas with Max, like I still am a real human being that lost her dad really suddenly and miss him so much. I'm happy that I'm talking about it and just being gentle with myself and cutting myself some slack, giving myself some grace, because I know that I can feel this way this time of year, especially if like any big things, like I've been saying with Max playing in NHL games, like I just want to tell him so bad. Again, it was so good to be with my family, my mom, her family, like my cousins, my aunt, my uncle, my sister over Thanksgiving, and see my grandma. And yeah, I just feel like so much better when I'm with my family, and I'm so happy I get to see them again soon for Christmas. I literally can't wait. I guess I can just give you a little update right here. Since Max probably only has like 3 days off, maybe 4 days off this year for Christmas, I don't really know. I don't even know what I'm telling you, because we're gonna have to see. And like I said, you can't ever really make a plan. Everything just has to be sort of tentative, up in the air, since you never know what's gonna happen or where he's gonna be playing or when or how, if I'm even going, you know, like we never know. But I think he'll just have a couple days off for Christmas, and so he obviously will want to be with his family on the Cape. I'm gonna want to be with my family back home in Albany, since we're on Long Island for Christmas, or since we're on Long Island for Thanksgiving. I think my uncle, my cousins, Lucy, me, my mom will all be in Albany, like my mom's house for Christmas, because obviously I want to be with them. And so I just think about how like as you grow up, it's so hard. Like what do you guys do that are married, or even if you're just, or fiancés, or if you're boyfriend girlfriend and you decide to do the holidays together, like what do you do? I know a lot of couples will do like, okay, Thanksgiving with like this side of the family, and then Christmas with this side of the family. But I'm so like, well, I want to go be with my family for Christmas. And obviously I love Max's family and want to see them too. But like, I've always had Christmas with my family growing up, and I feel like he feels the same way about his family. Like he loves my family and wants to see them too. But like our families aren't 10 minutes down the street from each other. So like, what are we supposed to do? And I feel like in the past couple years, if I'm thinking back, I would like spend the first couple days leading up to Christmas with my family, Christmas Day with them. And then tonight I would like drive to Max's and then get to see his family for a couple days after Christmas. But since Max probably has to come back to PA on the 26th anyway, I don't know if I'll be able to see his family for Christmas, which makes me so sad. And like, and I love going to Cape Cod, because I just love Cape Cod. I love seeing seeing his family. Brody loves the Cape. He loves running around the beach and just, so like, we love it there. Like, Cape Cod honestly feels like a little bit like home to me too, since I lived there for so long during the pandemic. And yeah, I don't know. So I guess my plan for Christmas is, I don't know, but I definitely will see my family. He'll definitely see his, and who knows if we'll be able to see each other's. Like, probably not, since it's only a couple days, but that's okay. So yeah, I just worry. I'm like, okay, so when you're like married one day and with like kids and stuff, do each side of the family like come to you? Like, how do you, I'm curious. Can you guys actually comment down below? Maybe that's the question of the day today, okay? Since I'm asking you already. Question of the day, if you are in a relationship, or even if you're not in a relationship, if you do holidays with like friends, I just want to know. I'm so curious how you do holidays. How do you like split your time? That's something that nobody teaches you growing up. Like, one day if you are married, you're gonna have to mesh two families together, and then how do you see both on holidays? But then you don't want to make like one sad. Like, if we were like, okay, Thanksgiving with my family, Christmas with your family, I don't want to make my family sad on Christmas when you go to maybe I'm just overthinking this. I don't know, but I want to know. Comment down below, question of the day, what you guys do for holiday plans. If you are in a relationship, if you are split your time between two families, even if you have like, I would never know because I had parents that were always together, but even if you have like divorced parents, you must have two separate like Thanksgiving, Christmas, maybe just pick one. I don't know. I'm so curious. So comment down below. Okay, I'm happy we're feeling better. Happy that I can talk myself out of crying. If I can just not talk about it for a moment, I'm feeling better. And I think Brody and I are going to take the rest of the afternoon and evening to do some self-care and just cuddle, watch Selling Sunset. I don't know. Clearly I'm in need of some just self-care and good vibes this evening.
It's later. We're having the best night, aren't we? You're being so good today. We went on the longest walk, you guys, so he is so tired. He's just hanging out. I picked up a salad from Core Life, and I'm so excited. I haven't had this one before. I was, like, in the mood for a Greek salad, which, I don't know. Oh, there are the tomatoes. I was going to say, are there even tomatoes in there? There's, like, chicken. Is that hummus, I think? Falafel, romaine. So I'm so excited because, I don't know, I was just in the mood. Like, this is, like, yummy and has some vegetables, which I feel like I could use. I could definitely mix it in vegetable. Yeah, but I just felt like not cooking, so we're doing that. We got Selling Sunset all set up.
Let's do a little taste test. I had like one bite of the romaine before. Get a chicken in there. It's like a cucumber tzatziki kind of dressing. See, I'm so proud of myself. This is what I was talking about earlier, where I used to, I'm not kidding, if I was alone, I was like anxious at all times, which I'm definitely more like paranoid alone. I feel like, sadly, that's kind of the reality of the situation, especially for women, just being alone, like you're kind of more, I don't know, you know what I mean? But I'm like so proud of myself that I went and picked this up, and then I'm like, Gretchen, turn off work for a second, like put your phone aside and just like decompress, watch Selling Sunset. I never do this. I'm not kidding. I'm not like one of those that's like, oh my God, like I'm so bad at relaxing. But like, I mean it. I am. And I never just sit down and like watch a show. I feel like at all times I'm like, oh, I could be putting this in my Instagram story and I have to clean this, and I could start like this load of laundry. Like, that's still in the back of my head right now. I'm like, I should start laundry. I want to put this away. And I want to get in bed early so we can get good eggs. Like, my brain never turns off, but I'm like making myself do this. And this is why I'm like proud of myself, that this is like a little date night for me, watching Selling Sunset alone, eating food. Like, I would never order out food when I was alone before. And then Max was like, Gretchen, you need to just like do what you want to do. And he was like, when I'm alone, I even more, I'm like, treat myself. Like, I'm doing takeout. It doesn't have to be takeout, but do you know what I mean? Like, and I'm like, you're so right. Like, I should just, and I'm like, when I'm alone, I like eat whatever is like randomly in the pantry. Cause I just am like, oh, I'm by myself. Like, I don't need to do anything crazy. I can just like eat whatever's here. But I'm like, are any of you, do you get what I'm saying? So I'm just proud of myself that I like set aside a moment to watch Selling Sunset. Cause it's gonna take me a year to get through this season anyway. Cause I like never watch a show. I'm like, I'm too busy. And I like got my little dinner. We're doing great over here, aren't we? I also have no idea what I would do without Brody. Like, seriously, what would I do without you? I would go crazy. Especially last year when I didn't have friends for the longest time, or like this summer, or when no one was here, and I felt I would just be like way more lonely without him. Like, I would start talking to like my stuffed animals. I don't know, like, where would we be without dogs, really?
guys just saw me clean up. I did all the dishes and look at what freaking came from Amazon. I'm so excited right now. This is like perfect for my vibe tonight that this just came in time.
It's an advent calendar of tea. Whoa, look at this. Oh my goodness. Okay, so basically I saw this on Danielle Carolyn's story the other day. And I'm like, that is so fun. I wish I freaking had it December 1st. Today's, I don't even know what today is. Like, we're already into December. But I figured better late than never. And so I ordered two. I ordered one to me and one to my twin sister, Lucy. She got hers earlier today. And mine wasn't even supposed to come until tomorrow, but it got here today. And maybe it knew that I needed some tea today and something to be jolly about. So it came. And Lucy told me this. This is so weird. It's not in order, you guys. I would think it'd be like one, two, three, four. One is right here. Then two is right there. Then three. Like, why is it all out of order? I don't know. And am I supposed to follow the numbers? I don't know, I'm just excited to try all of these. My favorite, wait, actually my favorite isn't even Puka. My favorite is Organic India Turmeric Ginger. I like their three ginger one too, but the other one's like just like a little bit more turmeric-y gingery. Oh, this one sounds so nice. Nighttime Organic Dreamy, I'm like reading organic, that's not flavor. Nighttime Dreamy Bed of Oat Flour, Lavender, Lime Flour. But that's supposed to be Christmas Eve, I think. Today, I do Feel New, Organic, Clean Fusion. Or should I do the day of today? What is freaking today? The 6th. So should I do, oh my gosh, that's the ginger one that I've had before. Or do I start with one and try to do like two every day until I catch up? I feel like I should try. Or can I just pick whatever flavor I want? I don't know. I also need to find somewhere to hang this. I'm thinking right here could be good. Like, this could be cute on the wall next to the fridge, right?
Okay, I'm immediately regretting my decision because this is always gonna be like showing now. And when they're like empty, it'll probably like, oh, I should have done it on the inside of one of these doors. Maybe I'll move it. I literally just used scotch tape. Okay, let's move it. Okay, they all are looking so good right now. Mint refresh, like I love mint. Lemon, ginger, manuka, cleanse. Look at all of these. How fun is this? Again, I'm really sorry I did not know this existed for Vlogmas Day 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but here we are now, right? Okay, I've been looking at all the flavors for way too long. Turmeric gold looks so good, but you know what? I feel like being a rule follower for like once in my life. So we're gonna start with number one. Can you tell it's late now? Look at the new fur rug. He's so sleepy. My tea is steeping, you guys. I can already tell that I'm so excited for this whole situation just because I get to try out so many different tea flavors that I normally would never go for. So this is like so exciting.
Okay, we're not starting off very strong because I don't think I like this one that much. I had one sip. I mean, it's fine. It wouldn't be my first choice. I looked at the little pouch it came in again to see what was in it. And I don't know how I feel about cardamom. And I think I really don't like fennel. Whenever fennel's in things, I don't think I really like it. And there's fennel in this, so I think that's what's bothering me. I feel like fennel tastes kind of like licorice-y to me, which I don't really like that. Some of those teas are licorice. Maybe we'll just make Max drink those. But I like the ritual and like routine of this every night. It just seems like really pleasant. So yeah, night one done, even though it's Vlogmas Day 6. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I'm gonna end it off here. Love you, and I'll see you in my next Vlogmas. Bye.